this with each and every breath. This peace, this harmony, always available to us, any moment that we desire. May love guide us. Any moment we desire to tap into the infinite tranquility that exists within our soul. So, if you're ready, go ahead, pause this video, and hop into something super comfy, like the comfiest thing you could possibly be in. Watch you lift into something nice and comfortable. And go ahead and have a seat. Then forever you'll be practicing this nice evening flow. I'd like to over in some sort of stage or cedar, you know, like herbs or something to awaken my senses on an even deeper level. So oftentimes when we're entering a yoga space class, we're coming from all different places. You know, we're coming from maybe places at work or a hectic day with the kids or wherever you're coming from. Relaxing day, you're just able to wind down. Wherever you're coming from, a lot of times throughout the day, we lose our presence, our physical sensations, the sensations of our body, you know, using our senses. And so when we burn something, awakens another level of feeling, experiencing the present moment, all that it contains. So sitting on my swing side to side. Nice, slow, soft, side to side. Breathing a little bit more deeply. Using your palms, your magical healing hands to gently graze your skin. As you continue breathing into your belly, releasing any tension that is stored up in your body. Now expand, feel the sensations, exhale, these big expansive breath, wiggle your fingers, placing your palms in the center of your chest and slightly bowing your head to your heart. Breathe into the space. Breathe into your intention for arriving on your mat. What brought you here in the first place? Bow and acrobatics. As you exhale, visualize any ecstatic or stuck in energy. Exhale, just falling away from your body. Allow it to fall away. Dive deep into the earth. The Feel the force of gravity and downward, natural, intrinsic force, bringing everything that you are down, connected to the core of the earth. Breathe, allow yourself to be still, silent. Any to think or label or worry or go over anything in your mind, the past, just put it in a little box, a box outside of your home, wherever you're practicing, just put it outside. Shoulders melt down your back. Now go ahead, squeeze your shoulders all the way up, 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 up towards your ears. And exhale, relax your shoulders down and up. Again, inhale, breathe, squeeze your shoulders up. And exhale, rest down. Beautiful. Go ahead and switch opposite direction. So up, up, forward, so forwards, down, 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 these big circles, just nice, easy, big push that hold that body in, and breathe in, and squeeze, squeeze, and then squeeze your heart chakra. Ground, adding an extra layer of sensations. Bend this way, side to side. Take it to open up your neck. Big circles. Side, down. Exhale. Exhale. Exhale, down. Inhale, rise. Exhale. And exhale, switch opposite direction. Inhale, breathe. Exhale, release. Let it go. With each breath, brings us closer to the earth, to our center, to our core, to our truth. Each breath, journey, awakening, journey into the sensation of the movement. So we connect our movement to the breath. Big breath in. So beautiful. So good. Okay, let's do some cat-cow for a second, but so you can see a little bit better. Seated cat-cow, we'll start here. Just around our shoulders. Use your hands to kind of like create a buffer. Fall back, let your body fall back, kind of like, I don't know, turtle vibes. It's like turtle butt vibes. Put your chin in towards your chest, let your weight sink back, let your whole spine to round. A big breath. On your next inhale, use your core strength. So start your movement from your core. Allow your body to rise, 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 rise. Inhale, chin lifts up towards the sky. And exhale, around the side. Inhale, rise, rise, rise. And exhale, release. Big breath, ground your tailbone into the earth. Exhale, let it go. One more big breath. questions and our hips all the way up. Exhale, all the way back. Nice little twist, nice gentle twist. Not trying to like, just like keep it in one straight ball. There's no need to overextend ourselves because a lot of times when we're overextending ourselves on that, right? Whether it's our joints are trying to like or the movement, or maybe we push ourselves too far. Our yoga mat is a representation of our life, and when we're overextending ourselves on our mat in the practice, it's often an indicator that we're overextending ourselves in our life. Just breathe. That doesn't land, don't worry, but it does. Just think about it. Feel into it, maybe. On your next inhale, arm lifts up. Take our right hand before we like switch to the other side. Just like loosen up our wrist a little bit. I don't know about you, but my wrist gets so tight from just like being on my phone a lot and, just doing all the technology things, all the things basically. Wrists are like, very susceptible. Let's just take our right wrist and kind of flip it, and then push it out. Trusting in yourself and the yoga to allow you to open and divine timing. One more big breath here. Inhale, go back to rise. Exhale, raise your left hand back. Twisting towards the opposite touch. Maybe you want to just crack your back. So then come back to center. Come back to center. Then it's like grab up to your tailbone. As you lengthen your spine, chin is aligned with the center of your chest. Release your shoulders down, your back, each exhale. Each inhale allows you to lengthen even further. And each exhale, ground you even more deeply into your earth. Our body is affected by these repetitive movements it's like a repetitive movement, especially when we're with your palm, it's not symmetrical, but that's just the way of life, and just take notice. So like if maybe right hand is like all the way up here. You don't have to push your left hand down as far as it can go, even if it can go further than your right. You can just keep it up, you know, keep it so it's kind of like symmetrical, and then they'll be like aligned. You don't have to like at all, if that makes any sense. It's just what I like to do to try and keep myself feeling balanced. I've noticed like sometimes very stark differences between my right and left side. One side feels very, very tight and the other is very open. And our right side is represented from our masculine energy, and our left represents the feminine energy. And I don't know, I guess I just like picture the two energies kind of like intertwining, and I want them to work together in sync and on the same page. So that's why I try and keep them aligned, you know, it's like in a partnership, like we're both partners, like the partners within. Okay, inhale, go into downward facing dog. Yay! Lowering my way forward. Inhale, arms lift up. Big breath in. Good, exhale, breathe. Hands go down, down, down. Go ahead. Side toes. Push back. Downward facing dog. Stretch out those legs. Pedal your feet side to side. Nice simple sway, placing, distributing the weight even between both palms. Pause for a moment, stillness, silence. And exhale, bend the toes. Keep a nice little bend. And go ahead, come forward, like almost through plank, but then walk your feet up to your hands. Inhale, straighten your spine, flat back. All down, forward fold. Here for a moment, maybe clasp your hands behind your back. Make sure your knees are nice and bent. Open up your shoulders, your cervical spine. Breathe fully into your belly. Release again, visualize the energy. Flowing down, down, down through the soles of your feet to Mama Earth, Goddess Gaia. Shake your head a little bit, yes, a little bit, no. Feeling the sensations of your head. And then finally, go ahead, bend your knees, bring your hips down, and then push your way up to stand. Inhale, rise. Sway a little bit side to side. Just nice, loosing your seat. And then exhale your hands down. We're going to take our hands below our hips. Just, oh, yeah. Nice, big circles on that love. We're quite low. box from the beginning of class and fling it out the window. We don't have to let our minds take control. We can feel, you know, in our body. Is it a thought that is causing any disturbance, or is there an actual physical sensation in the body? Because a lot of times our body will our brain will make up this distress or story, not even distress, it could be distressing, but it'll make up the story, sway side down, side. Make up the story and we'll start feeling anxious until we breathe and set your feet on the ground, ground yourself deep. Until we breathe and we're like, okay, show me, where is this feeling in my body? And it's complicated. Let's just bend our knees, ground ourselves a little more deeply. Breathe, inhale, lengthen your spine. Exhale. It's complicated because a lot of us are actually cut off from the sensations in our body. And so it might be difficult to feel the body. You might act like you might be feeling something, going through something internally, and you just can't feel it because you're disassociated for so long, likely due to like some traumatic events that was not integrated into your body, into your being, disassociated, or it might not even be there, but it just be your head playing tricks with you, right? Like creating these anxious thought patterns that cause anxiety, right? Because it's like the water experiment. Keep breathing, opening your hips. It's like the water experiment, Dr. Inamoto. When you think of something, you put the intentions into something, dip water, put the intentions into positive intentions into water, and negative intentions into water. You wrote love, you wrote hate on water. And what happened? When I looked under a microscope, the water molecules of love, same water, everything was the same except for this intention. These water molecules of love, beautiful, symmetrical, absolutely divine. And then the water molecules with the intention of hate, chaotic, messy, almost disturbing. And that's just pure intention, writing a word on water. That energy is the energy behind it. And so when we know that our body is 70% water and our mind is creating this intention, it's like, what is the intention that I want to create within myself? Do I want to, because if we choose love, we're going to feel more love. We're going to feel more love, even if it's hard, even if it's difficult, even if it feels like we're grasping for straws, we can find love in every single moment. And then we'll only continue to amplify and amplify and amplify. But if we choose hate, that's only going to continue to amplify and amplify too. And listen, let's exhale. Unfold. Spine and walk your hands over to the right side. Inhale, right arm lifts up. Nice little twist here. Between your palms, left knee taps down, left arms rise, on chance. Breathe in, exhale. over it right now. It's okay if you do that, but like try and keep it. It's good to stretch it, but not to like keep it like that. Inhale, heart opens. Exhale, shake yourself. Breathe in, exhale, bend your elbows. Now roll onto the sole of your foot. Begin on to the opposite of both arms. Rise up, squeeze those hips together, left, forward, right. Choice. The way that we choose to see the world is always a choice. It's our point of view. It's our perspective, and nobody can take that from us. It's ours and ours alone. Breathe in your truth. Breathe in your authenticity. Breathe in your experience. What is real for you in this present moment? Can you breathe it in, and can you trust that what is will be, what is meant to be and will be? Does that thought allow you to release just a little bit more deeply? Relax. Soften into the present moment, all that it feels. Breathe in that trust, breathe in that knowing. Allow yourself to experience anything that is not aligned with your truth. What feels to be true within you, you are. Anything else is absolutely entitled to their own truth. It doesn't need to affect you. Need to influence you, but is meant to be. Just breathe in, trust. On your next breath, slowly, slowly, slowly come back to rise. Keep going, you got this. Still the other side to do with love. Slight little back bend. If you feel any feelings, go ahead and push your hands down to your toes. If you feel any feelings of like wanting to, you know, just shut this off and don't go forward. Exhale, lower down. Shut this off, inhale, rise. Exhale, back, child's pose. Just observe that. You committed to this time to focus on your breath and yourself. Bring yourself back to your attention. And trust the purity of that intention in your heart's desires. What is meant? Your next breath, inhale, rise up off. Exhale, tuck your toes, push back down your face. Inhale, left leg rises up like that. Exhale, it comes into your chest. Look between your palms, right knee taps down, both arms rise up. Nice big breath here. Inhale. alignment. Exhale. Inhale, heart open, spine shapes. Exhale, go ahead, back into your elbows, release the body. Inhale, come back to rise, rolling over the sole of your foot. Anjanasana. Big breath, squeeze your thighs together, inhale. Lifting up and out through the back. Exhale, bring some down. Heel tap, heel tap your left foot to the right side. Inhale, heart opens. And bring your attention and your awareness back to the sensation of your breath. Exhale back, downward facing dog. Slowly walk your feet up to your hands. Now spine straight as well. Exhale, forward fold. Keep a nice deep bend in your knees. Slowly bring your seat down, down. Now it's gonna make a nice little ball and then wrap yourself back up. Just like massage out your spine a little bit. Make it really nice. Awesome. And then when you're down, go ahead, keep your right knee tucked into your chest and allow your left knee to kind of just like extend. We're gonna breathe here for a minute. And just observing your body, observing the sensations of your breath. Only thing you have to focus on in this moment is your inhale, your exhale. Exhale. Straighten that right leg, leg grab, gently clasp your hands behind the back of your thigh. Let your exhale fold the other leg in towards your body. Soften your shoulders. Spine, make any adjustments that you need or want or crave. Then exhale, allow your arms to take up as much space as you possibly can. Even if it means getting like a little bit weird in the position that you've never been in. Feel your breath within your body. Allow yourself to open up. Open up to receive the healing, the entrance, the healing qualities of one. Contain within each and every inhale. Squeeze your core really nice and tight first before you can roll over to protect your low back. Awesome. Oh, so nice. So nice. Right leg, extend it out. Left knee comes in towards your chest. You see your palms in motion. Breathe deeply. Allowing yourself to relax. You deserve to feel good. You deserve to be at peace. It's just breath. Give yourself the opportunity to experience. Still mind. No worries, not a care. Let's put it aside. Breathe in the trust. You are exactly where you want. On your next inhale, straighten your legs and breathe deeply in and out. Articulate That intention in the fertile grounds of gratitude. Breathe in all that you are, to release all you are not. On your next breath, inhale slowly, 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 and pass it away. Thank you.